to celebrate major successes for Nepal, the signing of the Millennium Challenge Corporation Compact, and the successful conclusion of local elections. Allow me to offer a few key facts that illustrate the growing strength of the U.S.-Nepal relationship. More than 300,000 people of Nepali heritage live in the United States, and thousands of Nepalis are currently studying in U.S. schools. Since the Peace Corps program was established in 1962, over 3,700 Peace Corps volunteers have worked in Nepal, and 60 are there today, helping Nepalis achieve food security. Two-way trade between our countries has reached $130 million annually, and we hope that that number will grow. And just 8 days ago, Nepal completed the third phase of local elections. Now, for the first time in 20 years, elected officials will be empowered at the local level to serve all Nepalese. The United States looks forward to Nepal completing further rounds of elections for its provincial assemblies and the national legislature over the next several months. Democracy is flourishing in Nepal, and I am proud to be here to congratulate all of you on this great achievement. In addition, Nepal's recent participation at the United Nations General Assembly showed its commitment to Secretary General Guterres's United Nations reform agenda, to preventing sexual exploitation and abuse, and to empowering global peacekeeping efforts. In fact, Nepal's decades-long contributions to global peacekeeping deserve special mention. Nepal has deployed tens of thousands of soldiers and police across the world to help protect the defenseless and prevent violence. We honor the sacrifices of Nepal's soldiers and police who lost their lives fighting for the common cause of world peace. The Nepal UN Peacekeepers Memorial Plaque, which was unveiled last week at the United Nations, is a fitting tribute to these brave men and women. New opportunities in Nepal are beginning to develop as well. A major symbol of U.S.-Nepal cooperation today is the MCC Compact. Between the United States' $500 million contribution and Nepal's own contribution of $130 million, we will develop and sustain Nepal's electricity infrastructure and its road transportation networks, which will lift countless citizens of your country out of poverty. As Deputy Secretary John Sullivan noted at the signing ceremony last week, a politically stable and prosperous Nepal serves not only the people of Nepal, but the broader region and our country as well. The MCC Compact is only one element of our commitment to provide Nepal economic support and assistance. And as many of you know, our colleagues at the U.S. Agency for International Development have worked tirelessly to assist the Nepal government rebuild from the tragic earthquakes of 2015. Since then, hundreds of thousands of victims have received housing reconstruction grants, and the government of Nepal is rebuilding homes, schools, and hospitals. I had the luxury of traveling to Nepal years ago on a vacation with my family, and recall my own feeling of awe and amazement. Nepal is a beautiful country with incredible, energetic, and warm people. I look forward to traveling there in an official capacity to continue advancing this very important relationship in all aspects. Our U.S. Ambassador to Nepal, Elena Teplitz, wrote a few months ago that when it comes to the U.S.-Nepal relationship, only the sky and our imagination are the limits. And she's absolutely right. Nepal has a strong and committed friend in the United States of America. My team and I will work strenuously to do more to assist you, and I want to thank you again for inviting me to celebrate with you here tonight. Thank you very much, and congratulations.